Rico, suave. Huh? What? I don't think so. Yo, Vanilla, kick him up time for him, boy. Yeah. VIP. VIP, baby. Yeah. Yo, this is the D here. DJ Cool Kelly D coming at y'all again with a big what's up. Gonna pretty soon either get some porcelain veneers put in my gums, or either I'm gonna get some dentures. I'll probably just get some dentures. This is the way I'm gonna be talking probably from now on. You know, I'm able to talk now in English and not, you know, throw my words up because I had the back row of teeth that was, you know, I had to learn it like 6 or 7 years old how to talk you like that. So now I'm talking like Adam Sandler, I guess. I went from through extremes, you know, like Billy Joel, I go to extremes being bipolar, I guess with speech impediments, you know, being Australopithecus, Cro-Magnon, Neanderthal man, to being Gigantopithecus, to being just a regular chimpanzee. And so now, I don't know what, I'm going to have some curious George now, but this is the way I'm talking because I'm not slurring my mouth, my words, you know. And for all those years, you know, I went from talking like a child with Down syndrome, with an IQ of someone in Mensa, which I was a member of Mensa for many years, so having a high IQ, but my speech impediment always kept me from talking English, you know, proper English and stuff, so this is my voice here, so, you know, my regular voice is deep, and so this is the voice I'm going to be talking in, yes, and so everyone get used to it. I want to talk to you about teeth, healthy teeth, you know. Healthy teeth is one thing we want to all have, you know. Everyone wants to have white, shiny teeth, you know. Nice ivories, you know. In like 4 or 5 weeks, I'm going to have this bottom row here pulled, which is like these here and these. You know, it's like, I think it's like 7 or 8 teeth in all. So anyway, without further ado, I'm going to take you to what my mouth was like. And you know, if you don't want to have to go through 2 hours now of being 15 shots in your mouth, and you know, them needles are big and they hurt. I mean, you actually probably about 20 shots, you know, 10 at the top, 5 in the back, and what is it, 10? Let me see, 5, 10. Yeah, five in the front, five in the back, five in the front here in the bottom, five in the back in the bottom. But today I had to have 15 shots in my mouth. You know, at the top I had a 10 across here, the front, and five in the bottom. So, that's exactly how many I had. I had 15 shots. And two, you feel the pressure and it popping and cracking. And also, I'm going to show you what the teeth look like. And it comes from not brushing and flossing and using a mouthwash. I have keep about 10 or 15 different types of toothpaste in my bathroom since I went to the dentist like in 2013 when I got delivered from cigarette smoking from the Lord in church. Went from smoking cigarettes to drinking Diet Mountain Dew. No, from drinking Mountain Dew. Excuse me. These damn Oxycontin Percocets. And I don't like them, you know. They gave me that for, they gave me that. And what's the other thing called? Let's see. Oxycontin is one Percocet. And the other one is, can't really see where it says. I think there's starts with a V. Anyway, they're you have to have a prescription to get them. I forget what you call them, narcotic drugs, but Vicodin, Percocet, Oxycontin, and Vicodin. I don't like either of those medications. I mean, they make me feel kind of crazy, even though it does deaden the pain, but And two, I'm hurting now. My top gum is bleeding a little bit. But the acid in the Coca-Cola's, Pepsi's, especially the sugar and acid in Mountain Dew's, eats away the enamel on the teeth, you know, fast way. You too. It really does. And like, your bottom teeth sometimes won't be affected because, you know, your lip, you know, and your tongue and your lip guards, you know, from the acid, because usually it goes to the front. Because, you know, you open your mouth to drink something, your teeth, the front teeth is going to be, of course, susceptible to the acid and the sugar and all that. But sodas is bad. Cigarettes. Anything, any kind of carbonated drink with bubbles in it, you know, is bad. Hot, like coffee is bad. The tea and water is good. Fruit juice is good. But sodas is a real bad thing. It's really what messed me up. And two, as a child, I ate a lot of candy bars and a lot of it prepared me being fat. You know, of course, from being bipolar, but being manic depressive most of all, being, you know, depressed and lonely all the time. But, you know, I ate a lot of chocolate and a lot of hard candy. But that stuff, and two, I used to break ice up with my teeth and crack ice up, and not knowing all the time, being an idiot salon, that when I cracked the ice with my teeth, that it was cracking my teeth as well in the roots, and so. And two, you know, and then eating junk food all the time and not brushing my teeth like I was supposed to every day, you know. I would brush them in the morning and at night, but sometimes I would forget a day or so, you know, forget to brush them or floss them. Most of the time I forgot flossing them. And I would use, you know, little mouthwash now and then and mints, but I always had a sucker in my mouth or a lollipop or, you know, peppermint candy or some butterscotch or something like that, cinnamon. And then I would crack the hard candy with my teeth too, which is a no-no. So, if you don't want to be for 2 hours in a chair, having 15 shots going in your mouth, dead in your mouth, and your mouth feeling like you, and you have to really, really be strong and have a tolerance for pain to sit there while your face feels like it's numb and you feel like a duck, actually. I felt like Jack Nicholson in The Joker. I'd be like, you know, it's a real crazy looking grin on my face. The whole time he was doing my mouth, the doctor was, you know, he was really good too. He's like Dr. Bolton, but he was a male doctor. Only male doctor there. But he was really, really, really good. I gotta tell you guys that this doctor here was really, really good. And the lady that assisted him, the nurse, was really good too. She was in the high spirits and joking with me, of course, and she had a real good sense of humor. I really enjoyed both of them, you know, and working on my mouth. And they were so professional, even though I'm a Medicaid patient. They either stitched me up, cleaned me up, got the shrapnel out of the, you know, they took the chainsaws out of my mouth. They got the shrapnel out too, the, you know, the bone and whatnot, what he could. And then he gave me some sutures, you know, got me right. So in 4 or 5 weeks, I got to go back and get the bottom for them. But I want to tell you people what these teeth look like. And you young people, you children, even you grown-ass folks that don't take care of your teeth, If you don't take care of your teeth and you want to, you know, have you taken any to drink sodas and stuff, sodas will mess. I don't care if Pepsi and Coca-Cola don't like me anymore. I'm one of the main customers throughout life. I gave, you know, wow, $20 a day basically to Coke and Pepsi. I mean, yeah, Coke and Pepsi. But mostly Pepsi. Now it goes more to Coke, but still soda, soda. And this is what my mouth looks like now. Matt. Hold on. Get up here. See? And that's what it really was about right there. And not only did he hit the, you can feel the pressure from him pulling it when it popped off, and two, he had to like cut the meat that was left over, cut the bone, and grind it down, the gum down, where dentures would fit. And they could drink nothing hot, eat nothing hot, but you can use cold ice cream, Jell-O, and anything cold water, cold tea. Relieves, anything cold relieves, you know, that. And I hope also to lose this big ass stomach. See that stomach of mine? It's really disgusting. I went from being 600 pounds last summer to being almost 400 now, which I got weighed the other day, and it was like 389, I think it was. But the doctor said that's good. She says I'm solid now. My legs are in better shape now than what it was. I was falling and stuff when I was like, really, I was 600 plus pounds, almost 700 pounds. Oh, like really, really fat. But this is what happens, Steve, people. You have to learn to love yourself. And dudes, I'm telling the guys as well as the ladies out there, don't worry about having a man or a woman. I mean, a partner or a wife or a girlfriend, boyfriend, husband or whatever, whatnot. A person, you know, the opposite sex or whatever floats your boat. I mean, for me, I found out that I don't need a girlfriend or a wifey, that I can make it on my own and live on my own and be happy. Long as I'm, you know, I love myself and happy with myself, I can make it. But here is what them teeth look like. Let me show you. And this is from a lot of acid, a lot of sugar and acid from sodas that eats the enamel away the teeth. Hope you all can see this. This is how ugly the teeth are. Look how ugly they look. See? Isn't that, you see the black looking stuff on the teeth is the enamel where it rotted, see? And you see, honey, that's not all the teeth that come out of my mouth. Actually, I had, I think, 12 teeth pulled today. And that's not all of them. Actually, it was 14 pulled. And see how long that teeth is right there? Good God Almighty. And look how nasty they look. Bad teeth look like a dog's teeth, you know? You imagine that being a tooth in the mouth, what a dog's teeth look like. You know what? A dog's teeth is probably cleaner than that. Because, you know, dogs, they have dog food now that you give dog milk bone dog biscuits and they're supposed to clean their teeth. And I mean, it's not like that. But I want to say that and share this, that unless you want to, 3 or 4 weeks eating nothing but Jell-O, water, tea, and ice cream. Of course, me, I have to have sugar-free because I mean, I'm not diabetic yet. Hopefully not. Will be again. I used to be diabetic, but it went away. But I use sugar-free products, you know, like artificial sweetener or whatever. But I want to let you all know this. And in fact, to say, take care of your teeth. Don't drink a lot of, don't drink sodas and mess the way I messed up, you know. Cigarettes and sodas are really messing in too. If you drink a lot of tea, you know, my teeth was really, really stained from nicotine as well as caffeine from tea. So, and sodas, of course. And the sodas with the acid and sugars along with the nicotine and the caffeine from the tea and the cigarettes and whatnot, really, really a mess you'll have chainsaws in your mouth. The teeth will break off like this one right here. Broke off in my mouth and they had to go in there and pull it. I actually pulled, they told me I had to do it again, let them know, but I have like a little small looking like pebble of a tooth sticking out and it hurt really, really bad. When I pulled it, it was just like a little pebble. And really, I guess the nerve or whatever, but people, if you don't want to go through what I went through and you don't like pain, take care of your teeth. I mean, for God's sake, really. Don't drink sodas and, abstain, really take care of your teeth. It ain't just about brushing and flossing and using, mouthwash. It goes more than that. If you have to write what you eat, what you put in your mouth, because the mouth is a sacred place. It can be the nastiest place in the world. You know, with the, I think the asshole, the rear end, the arse, the butt, the anus, is, the butthole is the cleanest part of the body, I think they say, compared to the mouth. The mouth is really germy. That being said, you got to take care of your teeth. What do you want your teeth to be, your mouth really, really rotten? Come on now. Mine's too late. See, the bottom teeth here, actually, they said they're good. See? See how white they are? They're not brown. Look. Like the roots, they're real white. That's because they were protected by this bottom lip here and this gum, you know? But these top teeth here were susceptible because every time I drink sodas, eat crap, drink crap, my teeth would turn to crap. So, you know. And plus, if you're like me, you don't like, you're not addicted to narcotics like Percocets and Oxycontins and Vicodin, please take care of your teeth. That's all I'm saying. I love you all. God bless you. Please continue to watch my videos that I have posted. Hopefully, maybe I won't be 3 or 4 weeks, you know, with not doing no videos. Maybe I can do this little short things, you know, who knows. But this is step one, and hopefully two, I'll lose weight, you know, more than I've lost, you know, recently. I do a lot of aerobics. I do a lot of sweating to the oldies with some friends of mine. Of course, we have a real good time. We used to, you know, toke a little bit, you know, some little herb and do the Richard Simmons thing, laugh about it. But now we, you know, we're trying to, put our pipes away, our hookahs away, and do it naturally, you know. So now we're enjoying Richard Simmons sweating to the oldies and the disco and whatnot. You know, just being natural, laughing about it and having fun with it, you know. And yeah, Richard, he likes the big girls. Hey, yeah, big girls like me too. Hey, I'm Richard's buddy, you know. I like big women too, you know, BBWs. Hello, ladies. And so that's how I've been losing weight recently. Been, you know, doing the record thing with sweating to the oldies with some friends of mine. Some, you know, fellow stoners, potheads, reforming pothead stoners. We were reforming, you know, of course. We're reformed. You call it reformed, you know. Couple of weeks. We're reformed potheads doing our thing, the Richard Simmons. And so that's why we want to lose the weight. But I know I have my teeth pulled. I got to lose, but I can't eat these, you know, this right here anymore. Peppermint candy, Snickers. Hamburgers, hot dogs, pizzas, Subway sandwiches, I mean, all those good things, cake, but anything I'd have to chew, you know, like a steak. One thing I will really miss, though, and that's for real talk, I will miss the sausage biscuits and ham and cheese biscuits from Biscuitville and Church's Fried Chicken, as well as fried chicken from Kentucky Fried Chicken. And churches on occasion have good chicken. And that's what I'll miss. But I will look forward to getting a Wendy's Frosty. And the beans, of course. The beans with, the beans with the spicy chili beans, yeah. Anyway, you all have a, God bless you, be peaceful, love each other, and be happy. And next week I hope to go fishing with Big John Earl and Horace, Brother Horace here in the building. going to visit Morrisville Apex to fishing some ponds and videotaping and everything. Me and the fellas hanging out fishing. But until then, peace. God bless you. Have fun with my videos. And if you can, until I can put more music videos up for my suicide prevention, at least hold off until I come back. I mean, don't kill yourself until I come back. And give a chance to watch my videos. If you haven't seen all of them, check them, some of them, ones you haven't seen. It still pertains to the message today. Even though it might be a video done 2 years ago, when I was really, really depressed and really, really big, it wasn't about me, it was about you. And my love for people, and I hate to see someone, you know, take their own life. So, that in mind, I'm going to let y'all be, and we're going to return right now to Mr. Vanilla. Ice, ice, baby.
Yo, man, let's get out of here. Word to your mother.
Kelly D.